appreciate your email this morning.
Good God.
This storm we've been tracking the last few days, I need everything on it.
That's got to be a mistake.
I do think we need to listen to what your father has to say.
I don't care what he has to say.
He's been wrong from the very start and he won't accept it.
My figures indicate that this storm will overwhelm the Thames barrier.
Are you saying that central London is now at risk?
I'm afraid I am.
I've been trying Mum all morning and she's not picking up.
No population movement on this scale in this time frame has ever been attempted. We're dealing with millions of people.
Please leave this area. Please make your way to higher ground.
We're declaring a state of emergency.
There's water coming in here, mate.
Well, what do you think's above your head, son? It's Thames. Run.
Professor Morrison, we need that man here. He's the only one who can tell us now if we have a chance to stop this.
This is turning into one of the worst natural disasters ever recorded. More than 200,000 people are still unaccounted for, and emergency services are stretched to breaking point. The scale of the disaster is a reminder of what the citizens of New Orleans faced 2 years ago. Londoners were taken almost entirely by surprise as the storm surge hit the Thames estuary.
The White House pledged support from all U.S. military personnel based here. Where are they?
10 Chinooks are on their way from Milton Hall, Mom.
Why is it taking so long? What are our helicopters doing?
All in the field, I'm afraid. Moving evacuees, transporting medics to field hospitals. And currently, we're airlifting 600 inmates from Belmarsh Prison.
Prisoners? Just make it fast.
Dow dropped 500 points before the close. What? The Nikkei's in free fall. Everyone's dumping the pound. Half a million trades in the last hour alone.
Yeah, but how the hell is this happening? Get me the Treasury.
Communication with the Treasury is intermittent at the moment.
Oh.
Moyes from the US Federal Bank is on hold. You need to take the call.
Arthur? I'm here now.
How are you bearing up?
Well, on top of everything else, the pound's taking a beating. Arthur, we need your help.
Unfortunately, we are all in the same boat. The dowel's been hammered and the dollar has dropped 3% in 2 hours. Our first responsibility has to be to stabilize our own currency and markets.
Yeah, but you can't isolate the US economy like that. When the River Thames overflows, it just doesn't affect London. It floods Wall Street too.
Point taken. But restoring confidence in the currency market isn't going to be easy. We need time.
Yeah, and time is something that neither of us have. And I don't need to remind you that the United States has major financial interests in this country. And if we go under, the impact will be felt all the way across the Atlantic. Get me the Treasury.
Treasury.
Whatever it takes!
Why have you brought me here?
We need your help, sir.
My help? If I'd been listened to when it mattered, this catastrophe might never have happened.
It's not too late.
I'm sorry. Can't help you. I need to find my son.
There's not much you can do for him out there. The best chance to help him is to help us. Your barrier breach model. We need access to it. And your projections for collateral damage in the floodplains.
They may not be relevant anymore.
Of course they're relevant. There are millions of lives still at risk.
I need access to my database on the university server, if it's still up and running.
Is there anything else we can get you, Professor?
Yes. My son, Rob. He's the best marine engineer in the country. His company is under contract to the barriers. Samantha Morrison.
He's in charge of barrier operations, yes, sir.
I think he'd head for Defiant.
Defiant?
Defiant Engineering, Rob's company. It's not far from the barrier, but it's on higher ground. There's just a chance they might.
If there's a chance, we'll find them.
Commissioner, this may all be too late.
But we have to try.
Let me die!
be okay! Dad! I can't hold her! She's slipping!
Okay.
I let go of her hand.
Quickly!
dead end. Hi, Christine, this is me. I'm with Mel. We're okay, we're safe.
Is that Mom?
We're in Canary Wharf. We're heading for Greenwich. We've heard there's safe points there. And we heard about what happened to Wick, and if you can get a message back to us, please call back, because we're worried about you. I've got a signal for a minute. Left the message. Hey, you were dead brave.
No, I wasn't.
Yeah, you were. You were braver than me. Listen, there was nothing we could have done, love. Nothing at all. Come on, we gotta go. We gotta go. Let's go find Mom. Come on. Come on. Come on.
Open the door! Open the door! It's getting high up, John.
Sorry, this can't wait. Mom, I'm afraid we have to shut down all civilian mobile phone services. Networks are overloaded. It's beginning to interfere with command and control procedures.
All right.
It may take me a few minutes, Mom.
Thank you. With you?
Yeah, she's here with me.
Claire, listen to me. You have to get to high ground. Do you understand?
You're breaking up. But please don't worry, we're okay.
We need everyone out of the cab now. Come on, girls.
I have to get out of the cab.
What's happening?
I don't know what's going on. Come on, out again. Oh,
God. Mum, there's water everywhere. Mum?
Claire?
Please.
Just, Claire, just stay together. Hold on to Emma. Just stay together.
Mum, I'm really scared. Mum?
Stay together.
Mobile phone service will be restored as soon as possible.
Oh, God,
careful, be careful. Don't worry.
You okay?
Where did you lot come from?
It's a long story.
It was like a tidal wave come right through the room.
Red, it's almost collapsed or something.
I'm afraid it's a lot worse than that.
Quickly, let's go. Let's go.
Are you all right, Dad?
Yeah, I'm fine.
You took your inhaler, didn't you?
Yeah, well, but I'll be all right for a bit. Listen, the worst is over, I promise. They're going to come and get us, OK? They are.
How do you know that?
They're going to come and get us, and then we're going to go and find Mum.
What makes you so sure she's even alive?
Because the alternative is more than I think I can bear.
Okay, we're here now.
Dad. Case, somebody's coming.
Find yourself there.
They work.
Two bunkers. Maybe they'll help us.
You okay?
Yeah, that's what.
I don't know.
Try.
I'll go and have a look.
Okay.
I'm having a look up there. You stay here.
Sam,
our service guys have scoffed all the biscuits as usual, so I bought you these. Tea, coffee. They're damn smart girls, Mum.
I was just thinking of all the times over the years when I've sat with worried parents, not knowing where their kids are, if they're hurt or... I had no idea what they were going through. After losing John, the girls, if any...
Mom, no ifs. Not with Claire and Emma.
No ifs.
One variable can throw off an entire forecast.
Keith.
Worst storm in our history and I got it wrong.
Keith, don't torture yourself. We all got it wrong.
People make mistakes every day, but mine's going to cost lives. Maybe thousands of them.
You mustn't do this to yourself. Nobody could have predicted this, nobody. We've got to keep it together and we've got to do what we can now.
So is it serious or what?
I don't do serious anymore.
What happened to us, Sam?
It just didn't work out. What? What?
I'm doing it again. There's so many things I want to say. And I don't have the courage to say it. Tony. I thought I could speak to Tony for the rest of my life. And now he's gone. And Dad, he's lived with what's happening today his whole career. And I've spent years hating him for it. I got it wrong, Sam.
There's no way out from here. All right. Look, I think I've got a bit of a plan. If memory serves me, about 150 metres down there on the other side, there's an air shaft. If it's not flooded, we could perhaps get to ground level that way. During the blitz, hundreds of people have come down and used these tunnels as shelters, yeah? Government put up these massive steel blast doors, closed them in, sealed them in from the explosives, right? There's got to be one for this station. They're under something official, like a tube map or something. If we can find it, get it closed, could buy us enough time, get that air shaft and get out, yeah?
Yeah.
Yes,
yeah. Right.
Yeah? All right.
Run!
think I found a way out.
Okay.
So, this must be what Bill's talking about. Where's Bill?
Safe here for 5 minutes.
I really don't think I can make it.
No
way.
Oh, you can. She can.
Yeah, you'll be fine. Look, you will follow me and you'll be fine.
Yeah.
Okay.
This is crazy. If one of us slip, we'd all go. And no one's gonna fall away. No one's gonna fall.
No one's gonna fall. Just keep looking up.
The latest indications are that the storm has turned. It's moving away, heading south.
That's not the point.
The crucial issue is when will the surge lose momentum?
That's what I'm saying. No storm, no surge.
But a surge this powerful will maintain its own momentum and for a long time.
What do you mean?
It could take out the rest of the city.
Are you saying we haven't seen the worst of it?
All of those people at the safety points, including your rescue teams, are at high risk.
Do you see that, Mr. Hopkins? That's just two people. There are countless others depending for their next breath on the accuracy of your forecast, as are we. Keith. Just keep looking at me. You can do it. Keep. There you go. Keep looking at me. There you go.
Grab on.
Okay.
Help, what's going on?
I'm all right. I'm all right.
By my calculations, the water will be 6 to 8 feet deep here, here, but only 1 or 2 feet deep here, here, here. So these are the roads your people should be using to get survivors to Greenwich Park and other safety points.
So these are our key evacuation corridors.
But if these are our only access routes, land-based search and rescue in these other areas is going to be well nigh impossible. I need more air support.
All our air support is already deployed. Our pilots are massively overstretched. They're already flying longer than is safe or legal.
And my guys aren't overstretched. They're fighting a monster out there. You can't expect miracles from us if this is all we've got to work with. My firemen are dying out there. Can't you excuse me a moment?
Down there?
Not good. Water's still rising.
You didn't take your inhaler. You don't have it, do you?
I lost it earlier on down there. But I'm fine. Honestly.
Dad.
Okay, not so honestly. But I'll manage.
We're gonna be all right. We're gonna get through this.
Yeah.
Oh, don't tell me I'm in a no smoking area.
I don't need to. You know it is.
I'm sorry. There's no excuse for what just happened in there.
No. But there's usually a pretty good reason.
I had a team go into a care home. The residents were abandoned by the carers. We were too late. The team are a mess, and if I'm honest with myself, I don't know what to say to them.
Well, you tell them they tried, and that no one could ask any more. And you thank them for their courage. And then you move on, fix the next problem. All of us.
Down.
got a light. Put me through to Cobra. Yeah.
Can you repeat that? Yes, that's right. Put them straight through. We want to talk to them. Mom?
Yes?
I think you'll want to take this call.
Is it Claire and Emma? Claire? Oh, yeah, that's fantastic news. Wait, there's someone here you should speak to. I'll pass you over.
Morrison here?
Dad, it's you.
Rob. Oh, thank God.
I thought you...
Yeah, I'm still here. I just can't believe it's you. Where are you?
Well, central London.
What's left of it? We? Is Sam with you?
Yeah. She's here.
Rob, I may need your help. I'll make sure you're both picked up.
As soon as possible. I can't tell you how relieved I am.
No. Rob.
I need to speak to Sam. Can you put her on?
Yeah, Sam.
Leonard!
Sam.
Oh, God, it's so good to hear your voice.
Listen, Sam, about the barrier.
What?
Do you think it's still operational?
Oh. Oh, God, well, I can't imagine the barrier's in very good shape.
Is there any way we could open the gates manually?
Well, yeah. No, you could override the auto setup. But I think access would be an issue.
Sam, I think the barrier is our answer.
I suppose.
But we need to rendezvous at Defiant first.
Okay.
Mom, we're redirecting four Chinooks to these safety points.
Commissioner. Here.
Do you have a miracle for us, Professor?
I don't know about a miracle. Tides ebb and flow like clockwork. We can tell the timing of high and low tide on the river 100 years from now.
And?
Right. Although the surge is still plowing its way upriver, the water level here, downriver of the barrier, is beginning to fall with the outgoing tide. The closed barrier, you see, is acting like a dam, keeping the water level high on the city side. If we lower the barrier, the water upriver can drain into the estuary. What we then need is a force which, in effect, increases the rate at which the tide ebbs.
Is that something we could actually create?
There may be a way.
Find something for this leg before we're picked up. I want you to stay and look after the others. Okay?
Okay.
You'll be safe here. Someone will come soon. All right?
Yeah.
Thank you.
Thank you. Storms dumped nearly 4 inches of rain upstream, and of course that's swollen the river massively. These locks, they're all at breaking point. To stop the surge plowing its way any further upriver,
I think we should open these sluice gates. Let the whole lot flush downstream. We'll need exact timings from the Met Office, of course, so that the whole operation coincides with the ebbing of the tide.
Richardson. Get me manpower availability estimates in these areas.
I'll check that off.
There.
But if we open the sluice gates, wouldn't we just be releasing even more water into the floodplain?
Of course, but if we get the timing right, with the barrier open, we'll have the water from the sluice gates counteracting the surge and the outgoing tide pulling it back down the estuary.
Hopkins? Where the hell's Hopkins? I need him here. Give me the waterways manager. It's Commissioner Nash.
Has the danger passed? Yes.
I believe so.
He's heading straight for us.
Safety points are filling up. We're running out of fresh drinking water. We're going to need to requisition more transport within the next 30 minutes.
Right, but make sure you coordinate with Ashcroft. Oh, I'm due to speak to the PM shortly. Do we know yet how many people didn't get out?
The latest estimate is 200,000, sir.
And so we ask for your understanding and prayers for those who are braving terrible conditions in a bid to save lives. This is just the start of a terrible day of reckoning for London.
Rescue services are undeniably stretched. And we have to face the consequences.
They're preparing us for the worst.
Loss of life on this scale.
Something we've never experienced before in this city. I believe London will survive, and we will recover.
Thank you.
Jesus. I don't think anyone made it. Not going to be out looking for us.
May I join you?
Our only reason for being here is to save lives. And God knows how many we lost out there. Failed. Or I did.
You've done everything humanly possible. Countless people owe their lives to you, including me.
You've seen the pictures. Who could have survived that? My girls are out there. I don't even know where they are.
What are their names?
Claire and Emma. Claire's the tricky one. Always round with me. Emma's the peacemaker, just like her dad was.
Sounds like a pretty unbeatable combination to me. This thing isn't over. Not by a long chalk. If we can lower the barrier, we'll force this thing back.
That sounds like the old Leonard Morrison who liked to cause trouble all those years ago.
Trouble? Me?
Any luck finding Sam and Rob Morrison?
Still trying to locate them.
Look at this place.
This is unreal.
Could be dangerous. Let's go.
Okay. Inside. Quickly. Sam, we don't have time for this.
Just 1 minute.
What about him?
His body's just been found.
What? How could... I should have seen this coming.
Oh, no.
I'm sorry. See if you can trace his next of kin.
Now, Luke's all right.
It's infected.
No, it doesn't really hurt.
Listen, this is...
Don't say this is going to sting a bit.
Let me see.
Oh, God! Oh, bloody hell!
Does Duncan make you laugh?
Yeah, all the time. Does it hurt?
It bloody does now.
We need to get this looked at properly.
I've ever done in my life. And I'm sorry. My
my biggest regret.
About breaking in.
But get in touch with Commissioner Nash at Cobra.
She can vouch for us.
Mr. and Mrs. Morrison?
Yeah.
Yeah. You're a hard team to track down. We've got instructions to take you to Defiant Engineering. Come with me.
This all looks great, but in real life, we're dealing with massive, unpredictable forces.
I don't care what your model says. There's no way we can gauge or predict what's going to happen when these two bodies of water come together. It's a hell of a risk, Mom. And the chances of it working out the way the professor thinks it will must be a million to one.
Leonard?
I've taken all known variables into consideration, including the issue of timing. I think my plan will work.
Crossley, have you and the Waterways team looked at these figures?
Yes, and I concur with the professor. They're as accurate as we can hope for at this stage.
Computer models is what got us into this mess in the first place.
Ignoring computer models.
Please, what are the timing issues?
Low tide at the barrier is 10:45 a.m.
For this to work, we have to open the sluice gates at precisely 9:15. The barrier gates will have to be lowered before the sluice gate waters reach them.
Barrier is not currently operational, as you well know, Professor.
Yeah, indeed, but I've spoken with Samantha Morrison. There is a way of lowering the barrier, but we don't have much time.
If the barrier gates can't be lowered, then the plan with the sluice gates won't work. Yeah. We'd be gambling with millions of lives.
So you're asking me to open the sluice gates, unleashing millions of gallons of water before we know for sure whether we can lower the barrier. How sure are you?
I'm sending my son and daughter-in-law to the barrier. Does that answer your question?
I need to brief the DPM before we do this. Richardson.
Oh.
This outlines manpower for key positions on the sluice gates.
Just when we thought that no one could have survived, thousands of people are holding up signs telling us they're alive.
Are people still alive?
Thank God.
Need the go-ahead. We're running out of time.
Well, I've already spoken to the Prime Minister about it. But I need to know, is this our only option?
I'm afraid so. Oh, we do nothing, and I'm sure you'll agree that is not an option.
But this plan hinges on the barrier gates opening when we know the electronics have already been wiped out completely. This backup system may not be operational either.
How sure are you in the work?
The mechanized override facility is designed to operate the gates in the event of an electronic systems failure.
Well, you don't sound too certain about it.
There's no guarantee that it will work, Minister, but this is our only hope.
But the key thing is that we...
So, we need a decision.
With a high risk of failure, sir, we cannot take this action.
Sir, we're out of options. We need to do this.
Minister. I'll go to the barrier myself.
Go ahead.
How's it going?
Awesome.
Are you sure you're okay to do this?
Yeah, I'm fine. Anyway, I kind of don't want us to be apart anymore.
Been picked up by a mobile search and rescue unit. They're safe. Oh.
Thank you.
Where are my kids?
They're all that matter. good to see you, Dad.
Think he's up to it?
Do you remember ever being able to talk your son out of anything?
He's so stubborn.
I wonder why.
Sir, they're opening the sluice gates. We need to get airborne.
Sure they will.
Commander Bryan, if we don't open the barrier in time, our ability to manage this disaster will be non-existent. Within 2 hours, this control center will be taken out.
I understand, Mom.
Give me Professor Morrison.
Certainly, Mom. Yes, sir.
Commissioner?
Professor Morrison, the surge is moving further inland.
Are you absolutely sure?
It shows no sign of stopping.
Has Fuller downloaded the latest projection?
Yes. We're counting on you, Leonard.
Understood.
I always hoped we might work together.
Not like this time.
What we're trying to do is very dangerous.
I'll take the risk, Dad. No one knows the barrier like me. It's my job.
Even if it kills you?
I won't let anyone else take my place.
Rob, I know I haven't been much of a father.
No, Dad, don't.
I wasn't much of a husband either.
I'm sorry I doubted you. It's obvious now why the word meant so much.
This is where we are, in the backup control room. This is the room we need to get to. It houses the manual override, which will allow us to drain the latch room. The problem is that this room will be flooded, and there's a good chance that all these access routes are also underwater.
So what are you suggesting? All the sluice gates upriver have been opened. We're on a clock here.
We need to drain the latch room in order to operate the hydraulics that will open the barrier. Now, even if we do make it as far as the override room, the barrier's anti-terrorist motives will activate, and there will be no way back out. The drainage system is only operable when the room is sealed from the inside. Whoever goes into this room is going to run out of air before the door can be reopened from the other side. This is a death sentence.
We need a contingency if they don't succeed.
What do you suggest?
There is only one option, Mom. The barrier gates must be destroyed.
We don't have the authority.
I'll get it.
Sam. Can't let you do this.
Whatever happens on this barrier is my responsibility. I have to.
Sam, listen.
This is no longer a civilian responsibility. As senior officer here, it's my duty. I need you both here to operate the latch release. I've made my decision.
You're a brave man, but we both know it can't be you. You don't know this barrier well enough. It makes sense. He doesn't know enough to go down there.
Rob, I'm asking you.
It's our only choice.
Minister, all our aircraft are fully armed and fueled. I must reiterate, time is of the essence.
I don't need to be reminded of that, Major General.
What is the status of the rescue operation at the barrier?
Well, that's difficult to tell at the moment. We're still having communication problems with the team on the ground.
It's all we need right now.
I don't want our handling of this crisis to come under any more question.
We are monitoring it minute by minute.
Major General,
your aircraft are to remain on the ground at the present time.
Deputy Prime Minister, give me a reason to delay this.
Thank you.
Yes, of course, sir. Commissioner, Prime Minister for you.
Prime Minister.
Commissioner,
I need an update.
Surge waters are continuing to work their way upstream. Their momentum has slowed, but we have major damage and further potential loss of life at Chelsea, Clapham, Hammersmith, and Putney.
And the sluice gate waters that have been released to combat this surge?
Current estimates suggest a confluence between the sluice gate waters and the surge in less than 30 minutes.
It's not enough, Commissioner. You're giving me very few options.
Commander Bryant's on the line from the barrier.
Good.
Signal's a bit patchy there.
Commissioner Nash, are you receiving me?
Yes, yes. Commander Bryant, a situation has arisen. We're under pressure from the Prime Minister and the military. Unless you give me something concrete, we have less than 10 minutes before aircraft are ordered to take off and destroy the barrier.
Mom. Professor Morrison is currently trying to engage the manual override system. He may need more than 10 minutes.
I need an exact time.
I can't be more precise.
You don't know when he'll be back?
Buy me all the time you can, Mom. Professor Morrison won't be coming back.
Gates. You take up. Get out. Get out.
Mrs. Sam Morrison put me through to Commissioner Nash, please. We've begun priming the gates. As soon as it's completed, I can open the barrier.
Sam, believe me.
No, we just need two more minutes.
Mister.
Hang on one moment.
I'm through to the barrier.
They only have to prime the gates
before it can open.
Prime Minister, we need to get the aircraft to the barrier now.
We're running out of time.
Good God.
Prime Minister, we need a decision.
Major General, you have my authority to destroy the barrier.
We have a go. You're clear for takeoff.
Prepare for takeoff.
Sam, you all have to get out of there now.
It's too late, ma'am. We're gonna finish this.
It's only a matter of minutes, Mom.
That's it. All my stuff. Follow me. Quickly. Get those transformers ready.
Any minute now, the sluice gates waters are going to meet the surface.
I know that.
Damn it.
Commissioner Nash, status report.
If you just bear with me a few moments, Prime Minister.
Sam.
They've done it. The gates are opening. They've done it. They've done it. The gates are opening.
Stand them down, Ashcroft. Abort.
I repeat, abort. Disengage. Abort. Abort now.
Left, he says.